Yo, what's up? I'm Fauxe. I'm a freeform producer from Singapore. I'm 28 years old this year, and right now I'm at Analog Vault, and I'm going to be talking about records that I found with you guys. So let's get this going. Okay, so essentially, like, I don't listen to a lot of music, so I pick a lot of things that inspire me based on technique and on the musicality of things. So the first thing I got was Waltz for Debbie by the Bill Evans Trio. If you've not heard of Bill Evans, I think you should, because some might call him a purist, but he's like what like classical music is to jazz, you know? The touch. He could do a show by himself and he could floor the crowd. And I feel that an album like this, this one in particular especially, is a good introduction to jazz and Bill Evans. Oscar Peterson. This dude plays a mean-ass keyboard, but more importantly, the arrangements. The guy has amazing arrangements for the music he does and the trio that he works with, or when he works with the orchestra. This album in particular was nice because, like, I like the cover. You know, it's kind of surreal, and walking the line is kind of the dangers that we go through with music, you know? You're always on that turf if you want to push. So Walking the Line, Oscar Peterson Trio, check it out. Back to my sampling roots, more importantly, Max Roach, amazing drummer, and not just someone that just plays jazz, but is really spiritual with his music. A lot of great breaks, so anyone that wants to sample like drum breaks and stuff, you know, check out anything from Max Roach. Check out Percussion Bittersweet. This is a good album. I've not heard it, but I know that anything that Max Roach touches is confirmed gold. So this is the shit right here. Max Roach, all you hip-hop heads. Ahmad Jamal, I think easily one of the most sampled human beings on earth lah. Anything from lo-fi hip-hop to anything that's experimental, everyone has sampled Ahmad Jamal, and you know, his playing, his touch, you know, whether the roads or, you know, just a piano, he is able to translate his musical thoughts really well with the choices of chords and notes lah, and he plays really well lah. Ahmad Jamal, one of my favorites. I started off sampling Ahmad Jamal for like the first 2 years of sampling, and I could keep going on, but you know, I think he's oversampled this point, but dope lah. This guy, I did not hear of Idris Muhammad until I checked out Chrome Sparks' Marijuana. And the sample was amazing because I didn't know it was a sample. But I think Chrome Sparks did Idris Muhammad justice because I think it brought a lot of people to this music again. Just check out Could Heaven Ever Be Like This, and then check out Chrome Sparks' Marijuana. Great arrangements, great sample. Idris Muhammad is a great musician. I mean, this is a badass cover. It's like Badmash, you know? Badmash means something like gangster in Hindi. I could be wrong. Has a nice like a restaurant in Canada or America. I can't remember. So this affected my music a lot, and especially what I'm doing now, you know, with altruism. Ornette Coleman, when this guy came out of this album, a good half of the majority of the jazz scene hated it lah, because they couldn't understand what was happening, you know? He was going not just freeform, but just really off the scale, off the chart. My favorite song, ironically, right, is the first track, Lonely Woman. Just play that, listen to the melodies, listen to the way they play. And this guy is so humble, you know, till his death, you know, when, like, you could still see people interviewing him in his home, you know, opening, and he's just like open arms and just welcoming a lot of heart, a lot of love, a true figure in jazz. And somebody I feel as well that maybe doesn't get enough recognition because I only discovered him just last year is Doug Curran. This guy is someone that I've been sampling a lot for a lot of my newer music that I've been doing, and with regards to the spiritual side of jazz, it's amazing to see how much, you know, music that has been influenced a lot from, you know, your African roots all the way to what it must have felt like to be an American or a Black American living in the 60s, you know, merging these two vibes together and then ultimately making something that's almost joyful, regardless of whether it's a sad song or a happy song. I think these guys did like wonders, especially with like choirs in the music, you know, the way the choir emphasizes on the melody, and I love that a lot. Very big inspiration till now with the way I make music, so check this guy, really check this guy, check everything from this guy. Alice Coltrane with Strings. I've been seeing this album lying around YouTube and everywhere I could find lah. With regards to the spiritual side of music, Alice, I think after she went to India and then she went to, I can't remember, like a guru lah. She was very inspired by him. And when she came back, she opened up a monastery of sort, like a temple. This whole album kind of speaks with that because all she does is just, you know, strings, synthesizers, singing. You know, she chants, she repeats like phrases from scripture, from Sanskrit, and it's a beautiful message. It's all love. One of my favorites, this is really one of my favorite albums. Alice Coltrane and Strings, and you know, look at it, look at the cover. It's amazing, don't you think? Now, away from jazz, Robo Hands. I've been following a lot of the UK music in the last maybe like 2 years lah. And I think like Robo Hands was a very good way to figure out how it feels like to just produce and arrange everything on your own. I always find stuff really quickly on like Bandcamp or YouTube. I know you're home, right? So it's just a quick game. But when I found Robo Hands, immediately like I knew like this had to be part of like what I was doing in my music. So I've sampled a lot of Robo Hands. Really simple music, not hard to grasp, but as a production value, especially as a single person making everything, even with help of friends, I think Robo Hands did a really good job. And a really simple cover, you know, just him just looking down, wondering like what's gonna happen next. I'm so glad I found this Spiritual Jazz Volume 8, Japan Part 2. This album, again, I've been on the tip of the spiritual jazz thing for like maybe like a good like a year now. And I think this compilations especially really introduces you to like, you know, how it feels to listen to such music, because it's really away from jazz. It's an ideology, a spirit, and like how you evoke that kind of like almost haunting persona, you know, when you listen to this. And I feel like, you know, it's also a great listen, like, you know, put it soft, like, you know, after work or something like that. But yeah, this is nice. This is a really good album. Really good cover as well, if you think about it. Ascension, John Coltrane. I think no matter what we talk about with music, we've got to remember that there must have been a root to something. And I think John Coltrane has set a standard that rather than it being emulated now or even overdone now, I feel like the spirit of the soul of the music lives on. Just as the name suggests, you know, Ascension. This is like heaven music. Beautiful cover as well, simple. With that all said, you know, I think it's important to firstly remember that we as a society here in Singapore, we are not going to bank on the fact that we want to just do our Asian roots, you know, Asian music. And it's fine. You know, we take influences of everywhere and we learn more about what we want to do and we mash it together or maybe create something else or be super experimental. Whatever it is, it's still your expression. But it's always great, especially that, you know, away from just listening to YouTube and Bandcamp, that you have more and more record stores that are popping up. I have never been into records for listening. I only buy stuff that are cheap for me to sample. But it's great to know that away from your home and the comforts of your space, you know, you can always come to places that encourages you to be yourself and also find a lot of fucking dope-ass shit lah. As simple as that. I hope you guys got a vibe from what I was talking about through the records. Altruism, 2019 and beyond.